विद्या, IFSC और इंडियन फाइनेंशियल सिस्टम कोड इज एन अल्फा न्यूमेरिक कोड दैट यूनिकली आइडेंटिफाइज अ बैंक ब्रांच पार्टिसिपेटिंग इन द NEFT सिस्टम. दिस इज एन 11 डिजिट कोड विद द फर्स्ट 4 अल्फा कैरेक्टर्स रिप्रेजेंटिंग द बैंक एंड द लास्ट 6 कैरेक्टर्स रिप्रेजेंटिंग द ब्रांच. द 5th कैरेक्टर इज 0. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, द IFSC कोड of a branch of Citibank is CITI 0000029. In this case, number 1, the first 4 characters denote the bank name. Number 2, the 5th character is standard and marked as 0 as a control character. Number 3, the last 7 characters are usually digits and represent a particular bank branch. These 6 digits are unique to every branch. As in the case above, the last 6 digits identify a particular branch, that is 0000029. Another branch of the same bank in the same city would have a different code, say CITI 0000028. Understood, Vidya?
Yes, sir. But how would one know the IFSC number of the receiving branch?
Vidya, the beneficiary customer can obtain the IFSC code from his bank branch. The IFSC code is also available on the check leaf. The list of IFSCs is also available on the RBI website. The code number and the bank branch details can be communicated by the beneficiary to the remitting customer.
Okay. Do all bank branches in India provide RTGS services?
No. All the bank branches in India are not RTGS enabled. Presently, there are more than 1 lakh RTGS enabled bank branches. The list of such branches is available on RBI website.
Okay. Is there any way that a remitting customer can track the remittance transaction?
Vidya, it would depend on the arrangement between the remitting customer and the remitting bank. Some banks with internet banking facility provide this service. Once the funds are credited to the account of the beneficiary bank, the remitting customer gets a confirmation from his bank either by an email or SMS. Customer may also contact RTGS or NEFT customer facilitation centers of the banks for tracking a transaction.
Okay, sir. How can a remitting customer know whether the bank branch of the beneficiary accepts remittance through RTGS?
Vidya, for a funds transfer to go through RTGS, both the sending bank branch and the receiving bank branch would have to be RTGS enabled. The lists are readily available at all RTGS enabled branches. Besides, the information is available at RBI website. Considering that more than 110,000 branches at more than 30,000 cities or towns or taluka places are covered under the RTGS system, getting this information would not be difficult. Now, Vidya, your next topic is NEFT, National Electronic Funds Transfer. NEFT is a nationwide payment system facilitating one-to-one funds transfer. Under this scheme, individuals, firms, and corporates can electronically transfer funds from any bank branch to any individual, firm, or corporate having an account with any other bank branch in the country participating in the scheme.
Okay, but how RTGS is different from NEFT, National Electronics Fund Transfer System?